Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to make this Surface Studio style textured graphic in HitFilm Express. So the first thing I need to do is go get some textures that I can use to make this graphic. And today I am choosing soundimage.org. They are free textures. They also have music and sound effects. But also texture images, I'm going to go to the texture metal section. I'll come down here and I think I will take this rust looking texture along with maybe this stain texture. And let's go with as much as I like this steel plate, I think I'll go with this metal texture right here. So now I have imported these in here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start by making a new composite shot. I think I will make it only 10 seconds long, and I will call this the graphic. It can be any graphic that you like it to be. In this case, I'm just going to make a simple text and very quickly formatting it and so on and so forth. So now that I've formatted it, I can actually put any graphic that I like in here. That's the beauty of this. All right, let's go ahead and set up each of the texture comps. So I'm going to start by making a rust comp, rust, and I'll just drag in that rust looking texture. And I think I will go ahead and fit to frame. And now let's make a metal comp, and I will just drag the metal in, and I think I'll leave it like that. And last but not least, we will make the stain comp, and let's go ahead and just drag in this stain looking thing. I think I do want to go ahead and fit that to frame as well. Now, just to kind of clean things up in the bin here, the media bin, I'm going to go and make a new folder. I'm going to say pictures. I'm going to call that pictures, and I'm just going to drag the actual pictures themselves into that folder so that way I don't get confused and I have my comps instead. All right, so let's make a composite shot. We're going to call this textured graphic, and this will be the main textured graphic. I'm going to obviously bring in my first texture. We'll use the metal one. I guess I probably ought to name that correctly, huh? Yeah, let's do that. So we'll bring in the metal. That'll be my base texture. And obviously I want to bring in the graphic itself. I can hide that. And if I come over to the effects panel and search for the set matte effect, I can drag that onto the metal and then source the graphic. So now we are essentially cutting out this graphic out of the metal itself, right? So what I want to do next is add a parallax effect. This will sort of create a three-dimensional look to it. If I invert that, and I'm going to take that down to about 10, and you can't really see much, but that's because there's no lighting on it yet. So I'm going to go ahead and add a new light. Adding a new light automatically adds a new camera. If it does not automatically add a new camera for you, then it will ask you, do you want to add a camera? And the answer will be yes, because otherwise you can't add the light. I'm going to go ahead and click on the floor plane icon to get rid of the green and red crosshair. And this light I'm just going to bring out in front of this a little bit so you can kind of see how it is being lit. Also, under the controls light folder, I'm going to change it from being a point light to a directional light. A directional light just gives it much more, uniform lighting. It's really lovely. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start layering in the other textures. So back in the media bin, I guess I will start with the stain texture, and I will put that above there. And if I open up the metal texture and I highlight both of the effects, copy them, I can now paste them into this one. And basically, it is exactly over the top of it. But what I can do is right-click on this, say, blend mode of overlay, and it sort of mixes them together. So now you can see that there's a little bit of the old one and some of the new one in here. Okay. And then I'll do the same with the rust. I'll drag this in. And again, I'll right-click and just paste those two effects and change the blend mode to overlay. So now you can see that as I remove each one from underneath the other one, oh, I can't remove that one because they're overlaid onto it. If I remove the rust, you can see the two from underneath. If I remove the stain, there you go, right? Now I could actually tint these, and I could do that in a couple of different ways. One way would be to use a tint effect and say drop it in here. And then if I decided I wanted to tint, say, the white part to be sort of green or something like that, I could add in more variation of color. The other way to do that would be to use a threshold effect. And if I drug that in, then again, I could, you know, one color or the other color, I could make a different color. And then if I increase the threshold, it's going to go down. If I up it, it's going to go more of it, right, all the way. You can create all kinds of different looking, interesting types of colors and things like that. You can actually add in your own personal, let me go this way. Yeah, okay. Personal gashes, you know, using a lightning effect or something like that. There's a lot of things that you can do. I'm going to bring this light a little bit more forward because I want it to, whew, man, that's crazy. I think maybe I will, you know, and I'm just sort of playing around here at this point, but I think I will take down the green a little bit. I don't think I need quite so much green. All right, so let's just go with that. And you know, again, this is to taste. You can texture this as much as you want. You can have multiple levels. You don't have to use the overlay. For example, you might use an add, would give a completely different look to it, or even a screen would also give a completely different look to it. If you just want to add those in, and then you can see that it's only adding in that green piece there. And in this case, I want to go ahead and do the overlay because I liked how that looked, but I do think I will probably just turn off these main threshold effects. Okay, so now I have my base sort of textured text. If I want from here, I can go ahead and make it three-dimensional. It's pretty easy to do, and I basically will use the same techniques that I've used before. I'll go ahead and create a new shot. I'll call this final. And if I were to bring in my textured graphic, there it is. I can make it three-dimensional. Again, it will ask if you want a camera or not. I'm going to go ahead and add a point, make it three-dimensional. And I'm going to call this the focal point. Dragging that to the bottom, I can hide it. It doesn't need to be seen. I'm going to add a zoom blur effect directly. Actually, I'm going to duplicate my textured graphic, and it will be the 3D part of it. I'll add the zoom blur effect onto it, and if I open that up, I am going to use the focal point as my center point. And then if I start dragging this into the negative, you can see how it's sort of creating this three-dimensional look to it, and you can drag it as far back as you want. And then to sort of just tighten it up and make it look a little more three-dimensional or solid, as it were, I'm going to use a crush blacks and whites alpha effect, and under that zoom blur, and I'm just going to change this to 0.01, and that makes it look pretty nice. If I want the camera to move around, I can do that. I'll just add another three-dimensional point. I'm going to call this camera control, and I'll parent my camera to it. And then as I rotate the camera control, things will move around a little bit. There we go. Hey, you know what? Obviously, my zoom blur is not attached to my focal point. Why, yes, it is. You know what the problem is? The focal point has not been moved to where it needs to be. Sorry, my bad. Let me go back and do that. I need to move that focal point super far back, like negative, 1 billion pixels back there. All right, now that I've done that, now I can move the camera around. So, for example, I might go 35 here and then keyframe it to be negative 35 on the other side. And then when I'm done, it looks something like this. So essentially, that's what we're looking at. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.